It's like when she's on the machine and she's like looking at the wall, just sort of like that.
It's the best line.
Oh my god!
She hustled you.
She hustled me.
Oh my god.
Hello, I'm Sam Thompson, and welcome to Reality Bites, the show that dives deep into the biggest and best reality series on TV. And right now, we're obsessed with 90 Day Fiance UK on Discovery Plus. The show follows 8 loved up Brits and their long distance lovers for 90 days to see if it's the real deal or if they've made a massive mistake and should call the whole thing off. We really hope they don't, to be fair. I mean, who in their right mind would put their love lives on TV for the whole nation to analyse? I sometimes do forget, actually, that that has been me for 9 years.
Wow.
Yeah. It's been a while. This is Reality Bites. Obviously, it's going to be way more fun to watch 90 Day Fiancé with a mate because there's just so much to talk about. Like Grandma Liz.
I'm quite excited. I've got butterflies.
And there is no one better to watch it with than my best mate, Fleur. It says mate on there, but I'm saying best mate.
Best. Wow, yeah. We've had an upgrade. Yeah. I can't wait to see this. This show sounds crazy. I love it.
Didn't seem that excited about best mate. Mate, you don't even know the half of it. It is such a good show. Get ready to be obsessed. This is Kadie from West Yorkshire and Alejandro from Mexico. They met on a dating site. They've been seeing each other long distance since last June. And he's coming to Kadie's house so they can meet for the first time.
Ooh.
I know. The thing you need to know is there's 3 people in this relationship because Kadie lives with Grandma Liz.
Ooh.
Good hug as well.
So cute.
My very own Mexican action man.
I'm waiting for Kadie to come home. She's bringing Alejandro. First time I've met him.
Oh, Grandma Liz.
I'm quite excited. I've got butterflies.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Meeting Kadie's grandma, I'm a little bit nervous. I'm so glad to be here.
She's done a Sam Thompson, done a linger. Nothing wrong with a linger though, because it shows that you care.
Yeah, I think she quite likes Alejandro.
Yeah, she does, she really, look at the way she's looking at him.
It's cute, isn't it?
Yeah, he is.
I think he's very sexy.
You look a lovely couple.
Alejandro is very attractive. He's for a catching man. He's always exercising and he eats very healthy.
You haven't been a mind shaker yet, have you? Do you want to have a go?
Feels weird.
Put it right up on his bum and his bummy was shaking. Oh, it was funny.
Wait a minute, then.
Why do you face the wall? She's put it in the
so
corner.
True.
It's like a punishment. It's like when she's on the machine and she's like looking at the wall, just sort of like that. And it's just like your nose is there.
Do you want to have a go?
And it just makes no sense to me. It's like, why are you not looking? Why, like, your field of view should be so much more.
I'm so glad you love him. Like, you've just bonded, haven't you?
Yeah.
We'll see what happens. Hopefully he'll want to move here.
Did you enjoy it?
It's not for me, actually.
Not for you?
No.
It's odd, but I'm here for it. I love her.
Oh, Sam, I really like them. I think this is true love.
They are very, very good, but we've got great ones coming out. So, Bridie and Host. She's got 2 kids and lives in Yorkshire. Mm-hmm. He's from Lebanon. They met online gaming, which I love.
Online gaming?
Yeah, because I'm a gamer.
You can meet people online gaming?
Mate, you've never played World of Warcraft.
I met Host on an online computer game.
I think we'll win.
We will win.
He was like, man, you're gorgeous. And I was like, you think so gorgeous.
So I met my first ever girlfriend online gaming.
What? Yeah. Okay, tell me everything.
I basically formulated a really strong bond with who I believed was a girl. And she goes, can I try on your armor? It looks really good. Now, so
is
I
that
then,
like a pickup line in gaming
so
world?
Then I, so then I then dropped my I then dropped my armor that she then put on, and then she logged out. So she nicked my armor.
She hustled you.
She hustled me.
Oh my
and
God.
Nicked my armor.
You got played.
I know. And then I called the police.
Did you?
I'm not even joking. I called the police. Yeah.
Wow, a lot
I was
goes
like really
on.
No, I was like really young. This wasn't like last year. Like I was super young.
I don't know with you, Zach.
Mate, you know. I had grafted, so you have no idea how long it takes to craft that armor. You have no, anyway.
You've
anyway.
Got way too much time.
I know. Yeah, I'm surprised I still have a girlfriend. Anyway, back to Bridie, okay?
Yeah. My God, Ramsey, if he proposes to you?
At the airport.
Yeah, how do you know he won't?
The first time he's ever seen me.
How do you know he won't?
Would be romantic.
What would you say? What would you say?
I'm sorry, I'm late.
I managed to somehow miss two flights.
You finally made it.
Yeah, you happy?
Very happy. I'm looking at her and she's the most gorgeous thing I've ever seen in my life. I've got a little surprise for you and I think now is like the time since
okay.
We're alone.
A surprise?
Yeah.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, let me just get it.
It's a ring.
Does
like,
the
surely,
shoulder thing, you know.
Surely.
What's that? What's that? Right, look, the way she looks there, she goes, I know what's coming. It's a ring.
When her said that he'd got a surprise, I'm thinking, is he going to propose?
I hope she likes it.
Is he going to propose? Like, is he going to propose?
Oh, his makeup.
Makeup.
It's not a ring.
I know.
I thought he was going to propose. He's got makeup for her.
I know.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That could be considered offensive.
A brush?
Yeah.
She's like, I know what a brush is.
My uncle thinks that I shouldn't propose on the first trip, so.
I love my bracelet. I do. But going home without a ring, like, I would like it to be official. Like, I'm putting my faith in him, but it would be nice to be able to say, my fiance.
I think it could be construed from a British point of view that he's trying to change her.
Maybe,
and he's
yeah.
You know, but it might actually be like, I want to, you know, shower you with gifts.
I don't know if this is going to last.
Well, the thing is, they don't look out of place together, though. Look, they do look nice together.
They've got the chemistry.
They do have the chemistry, and you want it to work. You really, really do. But the more you watch, I do believe the more you're going to see and the more you might say, you don't think it's going to work.
I think Bridie is annoyed at me because I might have invited like 6 other people to the lunch today.
I want to have lunch with my family.
Okay. We all. Calm down.
I just want to be with them because they are probably they already have started eating and we are very late. Hi.
These are couples that go out with each other quite often.
The uncle is living life.
I know.
Is that his girlfriend?
ما فهمتش أنا شو الحديث اللي صار هلا بيناتكم. اهتم بالأكل. كنا هنعمل حادث. والله ما نتصور.
اسمع منك.
عشوائي. يعني فرقت على قد كان فينا وقفنا على الشارع ورجعنا طلعنا.
Yeah, she's on the phone at the table
no.
as well.
I'm really sad. I'm gonna go back to my girls.
It just hasn't gone well. It hasn't gone well at all. Because this next couple, they're my favorite. I love them. This is Shaun and Christine. There are so many issues, but you're gonna love them.
I've known Christine going on 8 years now. We met in 2012 on social media. I clicked on her profile, and then when she accepted me as a friend, we started corresponding back and forth. We started sending small little messages, happy birthday, yeah, Valentine's and all that. And then I said to myself, there's something about this girl that I need to get to know her. Then she started video chatting me. I thought, she's a good-looking girl. And I thought, well, how can a guy like this get a girl like that? You know, I think, wow, okay. I like her quirkiness. I like Christine's, you know, she acts silly, you know. My future queen, yeah.
Okay. I love you.
Bye.
Give me a kiss.
I love you.
Yes, you do. You love me until tomorrow when I get paid, Deba.
I know.
All right, you love me when I get paid. All right, love you. Bye-bye.
I live with my parents. Shaun sends me money every month, around 400 pounds.
From all these 8 years that I've been with Christine, I wouldn't know how much money I would have sent her. But all I know is about hundreds of thousands. It's worth every penny. Worth every penny. After I've sent Christine the money, there's enough for me to pay my bills at least. And then when I look again, yes, I've got about 50 or 60 quid for myself. And that's more than enough for me to see me through the month.
And he absolutely loves her as well.
Oh, he seems really sweet.
He is the kindest soul you have ever seen in your life.
Main priority why Shaun sending me money, it's to support my needs and helps a lot to me and to my whole family. I feel that I have a financial freedom.
When I told my mom and dad that I'm dating Christine, they were very skeptical about her. She says, stop sending her money, she's using you and all this. My friends were telling me, Shaun, I'm off my rocker.
The reason we worried about it is because you hear all these stories about people taking advantage of others, sending money.
Hi, baby.
Hello, my sweetheart.
Last 2018, our greatest vacation in Baguio, God answered our prayers.
When she handed my son to me, I burst into tears of happiness. And I gave him a kiss and I whispered in his ear and said, I'm always here for you.
Daddy loves you.
Of course. Daddy loves you so much. I've met him when he was newly born. I've seen Christian 4 times. The last time I got to hold my son, 2 years.
Being away to his dad, he is always wanted to talk to Shaun. He always wanted and looking for his dad.
It is killing me. And what I feel gutted about is that my parents never had a chance to hold him when he was born.
How is she going to support herself when she comes over here financially?
I send her money once a month to help her out. For me to send her that money, it shows her that I love her.
As a best buddy, you've got to take it really careful. What we're doing is just looking out for you, Shaun, you know, just in case Christian isn't yours.
Oh, my God, look. He's fuming.
Yeah. OK, I'm getting a little bit mad here because
his friends are brutal.
No doubt about it, he is my son. I don't need a DNA test. He is my son.
He refused to take a DNA test.
Oh, the drama.
I know.
You're concerned about my well-being. I get that, OK, buddy? But Christine is the love of my life.
Christine, if you are playing a game with Shaun and you are stringing him along, I will find you, girl. And you will wish your mum never gave birth to you.
That's the best line.
No! Goosebumps.
What a woman.
Goosebumps.
Yeah, it's terrifying. I'm watching you.
Just to keep you on your toes, there's more than one Shaun, and this Shaun is a self-proclaimed international man of mystery.
I'm Shaun. I'm living in Kyoto, Japan. Oh, I'm 17. It's a joke. I'm 42 years old.
When I told my friend from university that I had a boyfriend from the internet,
the sinister music is killing me.
Yeah.
Her reaction was terrifying. Shaun does seem to have a lot of money. I have absolutely no idea how he earns all this money. No idea at all.
Honestly, I have no idea.
I love him.
You have no idea how you make money.
Honestly, I don't know what that they call. It's safe to skip this part, I think.
dodgy, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, it is quite dodgy.
Yeah, that's a bit weird, isn't it? The one thing I asked him was, are you definitely divorced? Were you divorced? And he told me yes.
Sorry.
Sorry. Okay. There's another red flag.
I don't have a secret from Victoria. I don't have everything.
It's just, yeah. You didn't tell me your age. Didn't tell me your job.
Yeah, so basically...
Didn't tell me you were married.
Truth need a right time to be told. So, I just tell her everything at the right time.
She doesn't seem to know much about him at all.
She knows nothing. We know nothing. It's amazing. I think he's a spy.
I'm scared that if he starts off on lies, is he going to continue?
Okay, yeah.
There are so many issues, so many questions, so many red flags. We went out onto the street, actually, to see if the public can relate.
I think love can make you crazy.
100% love can make people crazy. Yes.
It kind of like blinds you to all sense and reason and logic.
Yes, I've been in a long-distance relationship.
My now wife, actually, we first started dating just as I'd gotten my visa to go and work in America for a while. The worst thing about a long-distance relationship is probably not being able to hold them.
They're almost not real. They're like just a person on your phone or a person on the screen.
That's how you get catfished and...
Yeah, that's how you get the whole shebang of getting catfished and all of that, bruv.
These people that have like little white lies and all their stories, you can kind of... That's really a red flag for me.
When I used to live in France, I was in a relationship with someone in England. It didn't work out, but it was the distance, it was the unwillingness to sort of move for the other.
I'd be skeptical about sending money over in a long distance relationship, because you don't know who they really are.
I feel like there's a difference between telling someone that you love them and making them feel like they're loved.
I'm Richard, 41, from Preston, Lancashire. I'm in a relationship with Kathleen. She's 32 years old and she lives in the Philippines. She's got quite a large head in comparison to her body, but what a great arse.
Look, I keep sitting there thinking he's like having a laugh, but his whole life is the laugh.
This is him.
Richard is very handsome for me. I love his eyes. He is very funny and he talks a lot. He's not boring to be with.
She's gonna cook for me, she's gonna clean for me. I get to wake up in the morning next to her.
No flirting with other women?
I'll try not to.
What try?
I will flirt and I'm going to flirt and it's fun doing so. Trying to say no when little Ricky is going is very, very difficult.
No.
Oh no. My goodness! No. Kathleen, run.
Yeah,
run away.
Yeah.
None of that.
No. No Rickies. No Rickies.
No Rickies.
We're having no Rickies in this household, sir. Of any sizes, thank you very much.
I have a weakness for a good bottom.
When he came here, the last time he came here, he lost his phone and he was using mine. So all of the messages was linked on his email, everything.
And I was screenshotting the most beautiful of women or ladyboys.
I was trying to use my phone and then I noticed there were lots of notifications and he was talking with some girls.
On her phone?
Yeah, she caught me.
He said sorry.
I am a bad person. No, I'm not a bad person.
Oh, what?
I don't think I'm a bad person.
Right.
But like, let's say I'm a bad person,
okay.
Right? And I want to cheat on my missus or I want to talk to other girls.
Okay.
I am not doing that whilst using their phone.
Their phone.
You know, there's no, you can't get away with it.
He took screenshots.
It's obscene. It's like he wants her to know.
Yeah, he wants her to know. He's playing games.
He's playing mind games.
Playing games.
Playing mind. You're like a Psyduck.
Richard, I don't know.
Psyduck's
I don't
a Pokemon,
know. Okay.
You
know. Okay.
Yeah, you got to catch it with a
another
great
gaming
ball.
Gaming reference. Yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah, sometimes you catch it with an Ultra Ball, but. Right, I'm going to put my psychic hat on right now. Do you want to know what Shaun is hiding from Victoria?
Yes.
Or if Kadie's going to go to Mexico? And what happens to Grandma Liz? We all need to know these things. Let's take a look into my crystal ball. I predict that Victoria is going to confront Shaun over his web of lies. And Kadie will go to Mexico, but she's going to find it hard adjusting. Yeah, and Shaun is finally, this is actually just a hope, but he's finally reunited with Christine and Christian. Oh. Imagine.
So many predictions. I wonder if you're going to be right. Well, we'll find out later on.
I think I will.
Today, I've got a special event, something that I've never, ever done before. Quizmaster, the British nudism. Give me a hey-ho. Rocking out with my out. Kathleen's not happy. It was just a job, baby.
My hands are shaking right now.
Kadie's coming to Mexico. Just can't wait to be with her.
Me and Alejandro tell each other everything.
She doesn't know anything.
Christine arrives today, and I've got to convince her that this is her life now. It's been very stressful.
Shaun, you've got to come clean with her about everything.
She doesn't have to know that just yet.
I hope he will treat Mom right and Christian too.
I'm petrified of telling Christine.
Oh, Sam, that was so good. I want more. Give me more.
You're hooked now, aren't you?
I am. I'm hooked.
I told
I'm
you,
in
mate.
I'm in it.
Can't beat this kind of TV. It's so good. That's all from us. I'm so sorry. That's all the time we got.
Oh,
thank you so much. We cannot wait for the next one.
See you next time.
Hello, Daddy.